meal today, ma'am?
Oh, yes, it was amazing. I think I'm ready for the check.
Yeah, of course, I'll get that right away for you. Do you want a box for your food?
Definitely.
Welcome, everybody, to the inaugural Three Kids in a Trench Coat production. My name is Ryan Coleman.
I'm Kitty Clark.
I'm Dan Sagan.
And while the name is Puff Puff Laugh, we ask that you enjoy yourself. There is no smoking involved, but you can have fun otherwise. So. Mom, this is an ibuprofen. Mr. and Mrs. Clark, this is a vitamin. Dad, this is weed. So anyways, sit back, relax, and enjoy this next upcoming scene about a lovely family. Chloe Elizabeth Sampson, do you know what time it is? We have been worried sick about you. Your father and I delayed our sleep schedules for this. You know that took us months to coordinate. What were you thinking? This better not be about that boyfriend of yours.
Blake is the love of my life.
Chloe, we've been over this. He is not the love of your life. He is just 6'4".
Exactly.
We raised you better than this. What have you even been doing all night? Oh my God. Are you drunk?
No.
I knew someone drank my Patron. Chloe, how many times do I have to tell you, if you're gonna steal my alcohol, steal the cheap stuff?
I'm not drunk. I can do the alphabet backwards. Z-Y-X-W-V-U-T-Q-R-S-T.
No.
No, I always mess that part up. You guys know I'm dyslexic.
Enough. Tell Blake. It'll be a while before you see him again, because you're officially grounded, young
yes,
lady.
This is so unfair!
No, what's unfair is our teenage daughter stealing our alcohol, sneaking out of the house, and then lying to our faces about it.
Dad tried the new Thai restaurant without you!
You went to Titanic without me?
No.
How could you? You didn't even know about that place until I told you!
Chloe doesn't like her chicken salad. She trades it at lunch.
Well, Dad hates watching True Detective with you.
Well, Chloe won't lost her virginity in the back of our Mitsubishi Outlander.
I'm sorry. I told you that in college.
Chloe, language! You cannot speak to your father like that. You need to show us some respect. Sit down.
Remember those cufflinks that Dad got you for Christmas? They were a re-gift from his boss.
You bitch!
Me? You forgot our anniversary this year!
You told him?
No.
We've been married for 20 years now, Dennis. I think I can understand a last-second gift by now.
Well, you wear earplugs to all of Chloe's choir concerts.
Hey!
So, you're very tone-deaf, sweetheart. It's almost impressive. Honestly, they're a medical necessity.
Okay. Well, I know about those special little gummies the two of you take on the weekends that are supposedly for Dad's back pain.
Oh, whoa. This is not about what we may or may not do for our backs, okay? Our 16-year-old daughter is drunk and sneaking in. That's our focus.
Oh, yeah, because you two are perfect.
Chloe, first you steal our alcohol. Then you try to pin your parents against each other. You are definitely grounded, young lady. Hey, listen. We are not perfect people. You're not perfect parents, but we love you and we care about you. That's why we've been worried sick that our only daughter hasn't made it home. You'll be grounded for 2 weeks. Then we can reassess. Now, go to your room.
Sorry. I love you guys.
I love you too.
What are we gonna do with that girl?
At least she doesn't know she's adopted.
I heard that.
Shit!
Chloe,
on a life raft, but we must have washed up on this stranded island.
Well, this sucks. I hate sand.
Hey, pal, it's okay. I think we can survive, right? I mean, Tom Hanks made it look pretty easy.
I never bought a house. I never saw the Chicago Rattle. I never told Becky my true feelings about her.
Wait, Becky Humphrey from college?
Oh, the one and only.
I didn't realize you had a crush on her.
Oh, no, I hated her. She was the absolute worst. And now, she'll never know.
Hey, well, buddy, you know what? Together we'll get off this island, and then you can tell her exactly how you feel.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, and then you can tell her just how much she sucks.
Yeah.
That'd be nice. I have a whole list of zingers I've been wanting to use on her.
Oh my god.
Oh, is that War and Peace?
It can't be.
What is happening?
Okay, so you know whenever someone would ask, like, what's your one stranded island item? Yeah. Mine was always War and Peace, but I haven't answered that in years.
Wait, your answer was a book?
Not just any book. War and Peace.
Okay, that's the most pretentious thing I've ever heard.
Were you trying to impress a librarian?
No, I can like reading.
Yeah, but War and Peace.
Okay, just because you have the reading level of a second grader who was held back doesn't mean I can't enjoy refined literature. I mean, this book is amazing. It's got incredible knowledge on things like war and peace.
Oh my god, you haven't even read the book.
Yes, I have.
Okay, tell us one thing specifically about the book.
Well, it's written by Tolstoy.
Oh my god, you're the worst.
Okay, fine, I haven't read it.
Why would you even ask for a book as your item if you haven't read it?
Okay, well, joke's on you because now I can finish my summer reading goals. Thank you.
So you were trying to impress a librarian.
Okay, can we just focus on the fact that a book appeared randomly out of thin air? Did that happen to either of you?
Oh my god. This is my first iPhone. This is like same case and everything, the OG iPhone.
Give me that. Damn, no signal.
Oh, fuck.
Wait, you wish for your deserted island item to be the first iPhone?
No, I must have just said my phone when I was asked.
Oh my god. So our first ever answer to, like, what would your item be, is what's appearing to us right now.
Yeah, I guess so.
Why'd you say your phone?
Probably thought we could just call for help. Obviously.
On an island in the middle of nowhere?
Okay, I was like 11, so.
Oh, you had an iPhone when you were 11, okay. Do you also have a washer and dryer too?
Yes.
Oh shit, guys! It's still got Doodle Jump and Angry Birds on here.
Oh, hell yeah.
You know it's eventually gonna die, right?
Yeah, but it came with a full charge, so if I ration it correctly, I can play for like 7 to 8 minutes.
Whatever floats your boat. Marcus, did you get anything?
I mean, it's like this.
Oh. That's different.
You asked this question recently, or?
I think I just made some early discoveries about myself, thank you very much.
Okay, slay.
Maybe we could find some rope for you, too.
Ooh, you read my mind.
Yeah.
Hey, Cynthia, were you born on the highway? Because that's where the worst accidents happen.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry, I was just practicing some of my singers for Becky.
Oh, okay, not bad, honestly, yeah.
Oh, man. I think the heat's getting to me, guys, already. I thought I saw a boat right there.
Oh, no, there's a boat there.
Wait, has it been here this whole time?
Yeah, I guess my 2 years in second grade really paid off for me, because when I was asked for my one stranded island item, I said a fully equipped boat to escape.
Wait, what? So we're saved?
Oh, we're saved.
Oh my god! Oh, I'm so worried. Oh
my god. Jesus Christ.
Wait, where did the crop come from?
Oh, I just carry this around with me.
Okay. Let's head to the boat.
Wait. Do any of us actually know how to operate a boat?
Oh, don't worry. I attended the Miles Coleman School of Sailing.
Okay, Doc. Give it to me straight. What's the prognosis?
So you have strep throat, and I'll be honest, it's not looking good, but don't worry, we can fight this.
Can't we just use medicine?
Nope.
It's great what she's done for Iowa basketball, but the networks just put on women's basketball so they don't get in trouble. She went last a second in the actual NCAA. Lies.
The actual NCAA?
Yeah, you know, men's basketball.
Could we get the check, please?
Oh, of course, certainly. Right after I... Oh, welcome back to Choose Your Own Adventure, First Date Edition. I'm your host, Jack Backscratcher, and today we are here with Tommy. Tommy, how are you feeling so far, man?
Well, thanks, Jack. I'm feeling great.
Yeah, well, maybe you shouldn't be because this apparently isn't going very well for you.
It isn't?
No, it's not. Now, we all know how the game works. I give Tommy here two choices, and all he has to do is pick the one that he thinks will get this date back on track.
Wait, back on track?
Yeah, so, Tommy, first choice, and you know we start him off real simple. So, do you ask for one bill, or do you ask to split the check?
Oh, let's see. One bill for sure.
Oh, okay, great. Let's see how this plays out. Did anyone see where that mustache went? Yeah. You know what? I actually have a backup. So we're gonna use this one. And now will that be one check or two?
Could we?
Just one, please.
Certainly, sir.
Oh, thanks.
I figured I'd let you pay for the whole thing just because, you know, you ordered, like, the entire menu.
I got an entree and a side.
Yeah, don't forget about that glass of wine.
You had a Busch Light.
Yeah, exactly. A cost-conscious drink.
Okay, you know what?
Okay, and we are back with Jenny. Now, Jenny, how are you feeling so far?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Whoa, okay. Language. There are children in the audience. So... what the fuck? What's going on out there?
Well, he's insufferable.
I mean, it does look pretty tough out there.
You're the host. I thought this was going to be like Love is Blind.
Well, I mean, have you seen our budget? But you know what? It is your turn. So, first two choices. Do you ask if he has any brothers or sisters? Or do you ask what his favorite childhood memory is?
Those are my choices?
Those are your choices.
Okay, I guess the second one.
Great. Let's see how this plays out.
So, Tommy.
What up?
What's your favorite childhood memory?
Oh, that's easy. When I was younger, me and my bros, we went around the city stealing money from homeless people. Easiest $233 we ever made. Blew it all on a fire festival ticket, though.
Heartbreaking.
Right? Finally. Somebody who understands.
Okay.
I'm here with your check. Here's your check. And... I'm back here with Tommy. Tommy, feeling any better?
Oh yeah, I'm feeling great.
All right, well this is the special double down round, your opportunity to either go back on your first choice or you can double down. So, I'll ask you again, are you sure you don't want to split the bill?
No way. If I was with my boys, we'd probably just dine and dash. I mean, have you seen the bill? Like, what do I look like, an investment banker?
Well, yes. But, I mean, anyways, it was only $23.
Exactly. Wait, how did you know how much the bill was?
Because I'm the fucking waiter, Tommy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, still, not gonna split.
Okay, well, let's see how this plays out.
Whoa, Amex Platinum, okay, Miss High Roller.
Yes, Tommy, not all of us live off of cryptocurrency and singles stuffed into our socks.
Oh, okay. Sorry we can't all be corporate sheep and suck off Uncle Sam 5 days
a week. I work for a children's hospital.
Yeah, that's technically a corporation.
Okay,
I'm going to stop this. Jenny, welcome back. Final round, nearing the end of the date.
Yeah, thanks.
little time remains to salvage anything. So, your final two options. Jenny, do you ask for a second date,
no,
or do you tell Tommy that yes, he could, in fact, beat Caitlin Clark in a one-on-one?
Absolutely not.
Sorry?
Yeah, no, this is my show now. I'm not doing either of those.
I don't think you understand how
the
show
works. No, Jack, I don't think you understand how this show works. Right. If I have to choose either of these options, I'm walking out of the fucking building.
Gary, could you do that? Okay, let's see how this plays out.
Tommy. Sweet, stupid, ignorant Tommy.
So.
This has easily been the worst date of my life. Oh wait, no, the worst 42 minutes of my life. And I've been waterboarded for 42 minutes. The only reason why I haven't walked out is because of this stupid fucking game show, which honestly—
Please don't break the—
Hey, shut the fuck up! You. Jack, who the fuck is watching the show? Is this even being filmed? There's like 25 people here. You know, you. You have been insufferable. You have been misogynistic. I don't even know what options they've been giving you, but I cannot possibly imagine you've been picking the right ones. Okay? You might not be the dumbest person alive, but you better hope that they don't die. You are a walking advertisement for birth control, all right? So, if you excuse me, I'm gonna go home, eat a cupcake, and masturbate to David Attenborough. Good night.
Tommy, how you feeling, man?
I didn't expect that.
Well, I mean,
you should have.
You know what? You are very much not a winner today, but you're the only one left, so you do get a consolation prize, a brand new 16-in-1 CoverGirl dream bag.
Oh, hell yeah. I could give this to my girlfriend.
Oh. I'm sorry, you're currently in a relationship?
Yeah, she's such a bitch, though, dude. I'm trying to win a CoverGirl.
Okay, you know what? You know what? You know what? This was a terrible idea. We're shutting it down. Tommy, thank you for coming. Please get the fuck out. Just got terrible idea, Jesus. Maybe I'll go home and masturbate to David Attenborough. Bartender, can we get a drink over here?
Hey, bartender, how about a drink over here?
Hey,
come on.
What, are you blind?
Oh, yeah, I wish I was, so I wouldn't have to look at your stupid fucking face.
Oh, so that's how it is, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you want to dance?
Oh,
you want to dance?
Yeah, yeah. All right, let's dance.
Okay.
For Megan. Cool.
Could I have a volunteer? Not all at once.
Come on.
Yes. What's your name?
Joe.
And what do you do for work?
I'm an accountant.
Joe the accountant.
Joe the accountant. And then can we get a movie genre, like comedy or
thriller?
Western.
Drama.
I heard drama first. Western was a good
yeah.
Drama and then.
And then can you give us like an everyday task, going to work, brushing your teeth?
Laundry.
Washing the dishes.
Laundry.
Okay, so we have Megan, who is an occupational therapist. Good thing
Joe.
I know what that means.
Joe, the accountant.
Joe, the accountant. Drama.
With laundry.
With laundry. Sure.
All right.
I'm
And welcome back, everyone, to the 101st Annual Academy Awards. Now, you all know that for each Best Picture nomination, we like to show a little scene from that movie. Now, you just saw the Fast and Furious 24. Now, please put your hands together for this next scene from this next movie, The Shadows of Tomorrow.
Just another day at the laundromat. Oh, excuse me, I think that was mine? Did you use that laundry?
I just had like a really hard day.
Whoa, hey ma'am, I'm an accountant, I can help you.
Isn't that just like code name for porn star these days? I'm an occupational therapist, which we all know what that means.
But ma'am, I think you're stealing my clothes. And I was just wondering, could I steal your heart? I'm Joe.
Megan.
I see here you have a Victoria's Secret.
Don't touch those. They're from my ex-lover.
You have an ex? Nobody has those.
Yeah, I'm just really cool and popular by everybody.
Just stop me when, so I know how to compare. Oh my god, what? Oh, jeez.
He was also an occupational therapist.
No!
We therapized together.
Oh, I must crunch the numbers then as an accountant. But ma'am, we both have done laundry here for who knows how many years.
Do you have a quarter?
Oh, yeah, you want a quarter?
I do. Okay. Thank you.
Make sure you do it dramatically.
Do you have another?
Oh, jeez. Do you have a quarter, ma'am?
No.
Thanks.
Yes, and.
Yes, and.
Wow. The way you pushed that laundry in really got me going. I was wondering if you want to come back to my place after this instead of doing laundry.
Victoria's not the only one with a secret.
You know what they call my bedroom? The Shadows of Tomorrow.
You know when they say change is good? They didn't tell me it comes with a side of darkness. You know, I used to be the go-to guy. Talk of the town, the big cheese, Mr. Hollywood. I was the one that you could count on for a midnight quote or a friendly stroll through insurance field. Where am I now? Nowhere. Thrown into a cubicle at the end of a forgotten row. That's right. I'm the original Jake from State Farm. Remember me? Bet not. You know, one day I disappeared into thin air, replaced by a younger, fresher, and a slightly more attractive Jake, ever to be seen again. You know, I didn't even get a going away present, like khakis. You know, and the thing is, I still work at State Farm. I still gotta answer phone calls, and my hours are terrible. God, it's always the same 3 a.m. calls from couples in estranged marriages asking for insurance quotes. Like, who does that, 3 a.m.? What lives do these people live? God, but they took my fame, they took my khakis. These aren't even real khakis, they're just tan pajamas. When I go home to my kids, they look at me in disgust and they spit on my shoes. No one cares about the original Jake. No one bothers to check on me like a carbon monoxide detector or like a really old password that you just kept using from your childhood and only slightly altered, but at this point, just automatically fills in when you go to the website, so you don't even remember what the original password is anymore. That's right. I'm the Rainbow Unicorn 6969 with a capital R, capital U, and a dollar sign instead of an S of the insurance world. I am what Spirit Halloween becomes. My legacy, just like 1940 Best Picture, Gone with the Wind. Hello, this is Jake from State Farm. How can I help you today?
not that Jake from State Farm. Just a Jake from State Farm. Stop my growth.
Oh my god, you're so funny. Okay. Speaking of which, your profile says you're like 6'2". You seem so much taller in person.
Yeah, I've been hitting the gym, you know, bulking season. Doing some squats lately, you know.
Oh, yeah. Gotcha. Well, I'm gonna go get some coffee. I'll be right back.
Is she cute?
Dude, she's really cute.
You think she's onto us?
No way, man. This plan's genius.
We gotta be quick, though. We have baseball practice at 3.
Oh, man. My dad's gonna kill us if we're late again.
I know, dude. Honestly, I say we abort mission. My legs are tired, and I can fully feel your balls on the back of my neck. Can you think of an excuse to leave?
Sure. I mean, oh, shit. She's coming.
Gotta have my latte.
Totally.
Do you want to grab a seat and sit down?
No. I'm good. I'm good to stand. I'd love to stand up straight.
That's a weird thing to say, but okay, yeah. It's good for us. Yeah. I have to say, I was kind of bummed we canceled our date earlier this week. I've been wanting to go to that bar for a while now.
Yeah, I've been there a few times. I love drinking alcohol. I could buy alcohol right now.
You're at a
Starbucks. Oh, right. Yeah, I gotta go. You know, work called. You know how it is to be an engineer.
Oh, where is it that you work again?
Bob's Builders.
That's so weird. My cousin works there. Jeff Gary?
Oh, we must work in different compartments.
Departments.
Departments!
How'd you do that?
just cough.
Oh, okay.
Eyes up here, come on.
Don't even call me out like that, Paul.
Come on. You know what? I better get going. I'll see you later.
Oh, maybe we could get together again sometime?
Totally.
Maybe for ice cream.
Oh, I'd really love that. And then maybe we can hang out on the swing set after, or...
Oh, wow, that's so romantic. I can't wait. Bye. Oh, do you need me to get the door?
No, okay. We're good. I'm good.
Your dick's really strong. I just opened that door.
There's the sawfish.
Oh, and there's the hammerhead.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look down here. It's a shovel-headed carp.
Ooh, and there's... Oh, it's the clipper tuna.
Oh, yep. Man, the tool shed aquarium's pretty great, huh?
Thank you. Mr. Newhouse.
Hello? Who is this?
Listen closely. I have someone you care about, and if you ever want to see them again, you'll do exactly as I say.
Who are you? What are you talking about?
Those details don't matter right now. What matters is that you follow my instructions precisely. I have Kayla.
Kayla? You monster. What kind of sick game are you playing?
You have 72 hours to get $1 million in cash to the address I provide. If you involve the authorities or anyone else, your girlfriend here will suffer the consequences.
Yeah, I don't know if we'd say girlfriend. We're not really, like, in the labels.
Okay. Situation's a lot more complicated than that.
Okay, well, time is ticking. You have 72 hours. If I don't get that money, your friend here will suffer the consequences.
Whoa, 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 whoa. I mean, we're definitely more than friends. Right?
No, definitely more than friends.
It's
not like girlfriend, boyfriend.
Yeah, I don't care. If you don't give me that money, your girl gets it.
Let me be clear. I'm no one's girl. I don't belong to anyone.
As a feminist, I support that.
James!
Okay, I'll leave her alone. I'll get you the money. I'll get you the money. Baby, don't worry. I'll get you out of
here. Whoa. He can call you baby, but I get yelled at for calling you his girlfriend.
You also called me his girl, which isn't very progressive of you. It's 2024.
Oh, my apologies. How did you two even meet, anyways?
Well, Mr. Nosy, we met at the annual Chi Eta Pi Social, if you must know.
Oh, man. The Chi Eta Pi Social. I saw her across the room. There she was, looking so beautiful. Oh, man.
He was there.
And then our eyes met, and it was destiny. We were meant to be together.
It was my first time on shrooms.
Okay, you're not dating, you're just like hooking up? Is this a friends with benefits situation?
Boyfriend and girlfriend just sounds so serious. Like, we're still young, we're free spirits. It's not like we're planning our lives together or anything.
Yeah, it's not like we're thinking about our three kids, Augustus, Theodore, and Alice, and our two dogs, Max and Buster, and living in that big old house in Maine with a wraparound porch, which is perfect for the 4th of July.
Ew, James, imagine.
Yeah, who would ever think of that?
Okay, you know, I'm just an objective third party, but sounds like you two need to figure out what's going on here.
I'm kidnapped and you're holding me ransom?
No, not here with your boy, James.
Hey, I'm nobody's boy. I'm my own man.
As a feminist, I support that statement.
God, you two are annoying. You know, I don't care what you call yourselves. If you don't get me that money, Kayla dies.
Okay, you're right. We need to focus on what's important. So what are we, Kayla?
We're having this conversation right now? Yeah. Seriously?
I just think we can't keep beating around the bush. I'm avoiding this conversation.
Labels make everything so complicated. Can't we just enjoy being together without putting a label on it?
We've been enjoying it for 3 years now.
Whoa. I'm sorry. 3 years? You've been together for 3 years, and you won't put a label on it.
We're mature enough to know that what we have doesn't need to be defined.
Okay. So, let me get this straight. You're about to hand over $1 million for a girl who won't even acknowledge you as his girlfriend? That's rough, dude.
I mean, you're right, I've invested so much in this situationship already. Like, where am I even gonna get that money?
You went to Northwestern, James. Daddy has $1 million.
It's about more than just the money, though. I mean, we went on every family vacation. You're my emergency contact. We had shower sex. That's like fourth base. That's real relationships.
Oh my god, okay. Sorry that I hooked up with your friend last night. Or that I don't let you hold my hand in public. Or that I told my parents you're my gay best friend.
Is that why they got us those Beyonce tickets?
I mean, great show though, right?
Oh, she's incredible. Can we just focus on the fact that I'm literally kidnapped right now? James, stop fucking around and help me.
You know what, James? I might not be the best guy in the world, but I gotta say, you deserve better, man. You deserve to be with someone who wants to be with you. I know leaving something so comfortable isn't easy, but walking away is the best thing you can do. You know, when you go through life wearing rose-colored glasses, all red flags just look like flags. Someday, someone better will come along and show you that love doesn't have to be hidden for it to be meaningful.
Right, Kayla?
Oh, hang on. Let me put you back on speakerphone. Okay, go ahead, buddy.
I finally know what to call our situationship. Done.
Ooh.
I'm gonna find someone worth losing $1 million for.
Whoa! I mean, you should still get me that money.
And I'm no longer coming to your rescue.
James, buddy, can't you work this out?
And for the record, I don't think that lemonade is better than Renaissance. Goodbye, Caleb. Have a nice life.
Whoa, no, James, come on, buddy. Remember, guy ate a pie. It was destiny. Come on, man.
So, what are you doing tonight?
Really? I kidnapped you!
Joke's on you, I'm into this.
Sam, Vanessa, show us what you've got.
Together. It's like you're the only ones in the room. Mm-hmm. Hey, how long have you guys been a couple?
Oh, no, we're siblings.
We're brother and sister.
Oh. I don't know how I feel about that.
Okay, well, let's get back to the music. On Stars Align, we want to make sure that you're versatile artists. So can you show us anything different?
We could do a country song.
That'd be great.
It's a quarter after one. I'm a little drunk and I need you now. I said I wouldn't come, but I'm a little drunk and I need you now. And I don't know how I could do it.
step siblings though, right? Or...
No, same mom and dad.
You don't see the resemblance?
We look just like each other.
I guess not, no. I don't.
Okay, I appreciate that you did different genres, but I feel like those two songs shared a certain qualities. Can you play something completely different?
Yeah, we can do some R&B.
I'ma take you home.
Thank you for your audition, but we're gonna look for something else.
What?
You may
what?
Be, please.
Wait,
you may
go. Jeans, you said you really liked us.
Yeah, you said we were really cute together.
Jeans. No. No. I did not have all of the information at the time. Thank you. You can leave.
What? Wait.
Please.
We know we're good. Please, just one more song. You can't deny we've got something special.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Please, this means everything to us. We drove like 10 hours and 7 minutes to be here. Just one more song, please. Please.
Okay. You get one more song. No love songs. No sexual connotations, hanky-panky, whatever. Just pure, straightforward music.
Okay.
I usually... don't give up second chances, so don't make me regret this.
Okay, no problem. No problem. Should we?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Not a love song.
No.
No sexual connotations.
Please.
Nothing. Just a song that is near and dear to our hearts.
No games. This song is just pure nostalgia for us.
Okay. Kids in a trench coat. We are so glad that you could come out.
Yeah.
We're going to be sticking around in the bar out there afterwards.
Yes. Buy drinks.
Buy us drinks.
Woo!
If you liked it, please let us know. If you didn't, drive home safely.
Happy night!